guys, it's Tanita and I'm back with another YouTube video. I know I've been gone for like a really long time and I apologize. I know I always say this. Oh my god, I need to move the mirror out of the way because it's bothering me. But yeah, I've been gone for a really long time, maybe about like 6 months, because I remember the last of my videos was in May, I believe, and it was the video where I was explaining why I don't get to go to prom. I didn't notice that my earring was backwards. But yeah, that was my last video. I'll give a little update on how like life has been at the end of this video, but today's video is going to be about the time, like a story time about how I lost my phone at a Tyler the Creator concert that I just recently went to like a month ago. So if you're interested in that, if you're interested in what I've been like up to and stuff like that, please keep watching. And without further ado, let's get started. So this all takes place on like October 12th, and that day was already like pretty hectic. Like I went to the mall to go get an outfit because I didn't have an outfit. And I think I got like 2 shirts and like a couple of like accessories and stuff like that. Yeah, everything was just chill, and then we left for the venue. One of my brother's friends had picked us up and drove us there. The lines were like really, really, really long. Like, I don't even know how to like, you know, make it to seem interesting, but like the lines were like super, super, super long, and we were kind of just like, is there only one line? Like, how do we get in? And by the way, this was my first concert. And I lost my phone, which was very responsible of me, but once we got like moved up a little bit in our line, the really, really long line, we were talking to the security guard, and we were like, oh, are there like multiple lines, like how do we do this? And he's like, any line is an okay line. This lady came out and she's like, there's multiple lines, this is not the only line, blah blah blah. And everybody's just like, why are we just in this line, you know? So we run over, and I think it was this girl like in front of me, she reeked of alcohol, and I knew she was like a minor, but she smelled like, ugh, like gross, no offense, but like she was like, are you guys like front row, like are you guys like floor seats? And I'm like, yeah. And she's like, you guys are gonna need a wristband in order to get to floor seats. And we were like, okay. And so my brother and his girlfriend, they like walk to go see where the wristbands are. And they had to take me, but we were like, okay, we're just gonna go in and see what happens, because you know, like there's people getting in who have floor, there are people that are getting in who don't have wristbands and you know still have floor seats, so like who knows. So we get in and we go by the metal detectors and stuff like that, and I ask the security lady like next to me, like right when I enter, and I'm like, do we need a wristband for floor seats? And she's like, oh yeah, but if you guys come through my line again, you know, I'll let you in, because I already know you don't have to go to the metal detectors or anything. And so when I tell you, the line for the floor seat wristbands were so long. So me being the bright person I am, we decided to skim the line. So the line was like super, super, super long, and I'm just like walking across like by everybody. But we still had to like wait in order to get our wristbands and everything. And right as we're like, you know, nearing the wristband station, I hear Goldlink get on stage and perform Crew, and I'm like, what the heck? I was so mad. And it was like, I don't even get to record him. Like, I love this song. I'm gonna be so upset if I miss his set. And then so we ended up going inside, and then I caught this video of Goldlink. I love him so much. I love him so much. Now, after this video was taken, this is where all havoc breaks loose, sistar. Okay, so he was performing You Say. I like reach down to my pocket and I'm like, oh my god, I want to record this, and my phone's not in my pocket, and I'm like, maybe it's in my other pocket. I put my hand in my other pocket, it's not in my other pocket either, and I'm like, okay, maybe I put it in my bag. I check in my bag, It's not in there at all. And I'm like, what? And so I look on the ground, you know, I'm like skimming around. And then I think my brother, he was asking, he was like, what happened? And I was like, I don't have my phone. And he was like, what? And by this time, we already kind of like scooted up a little more. So like there was people behind us too. Like, because when we first got in there, there wasn't like many people behind us. But there started to like become a crowd behind us. And I was just like, oh my God, we're going to lose our spots. One, two, I'm not going to get close to stage to see Blood Orange, and I'm not gonna be able to see Tyler, especially because I'm really short and I like kind of wanted to get really close to stage. But now I have to go find my phone because I lost my phone. Like, it's stupid. I'm an idiot. So we kind of like slither out the crowd, me and my brother, and you know, we're kind of like asking around, like asking like bodyguards and everything like that, and they're just like, yeah, we haven't seen a phone. And I'm like, you know, looking around like outside of the venue, because I'm like, maybe somebody took it, but like they were scared till they dropped it or something like that. And nobody seen it, and I was just like, okay, what is going on? And we had a little bit of time before Blood Orange came out, and so my smart self was like, find your iPhone. Duh, like, I don't know why I didn't think of that before. Me, being not the smart person, you know, I take my brother's girlfriend's phone and I tried to log in. So I don't know my password for my little Apple thing. And I'm like, okay, I'm stupid. And then I finally like remembered, no, I changed it. No, I didn't. No, I remembered it. And then I get signed in and it's like, you have to like have it set up, and I didn't know that because I didn't find my iPhone set up. I thought it would just like, you know, connect or whatever, and I didn't have it set up. So your girl was out of luck, and I was like, oh my God, somebody like probably has my phone, and they're gonna turn it in as if it's theirs, and they're gonna get a new brand new shiny freaking iPhone 11 with my phone. I'm gonna jailbreak it and then take all my pictures. It's not like I had like anything like gross on it. I'm not that kind of person. But like, I have pictures of my niece and my nephew and my face on it. You know, somebody could catfish to be me. Like, I don't want, like, the possibilities are endless. You know what I mean? And I also don't want to die because that's my only phone. And I don't have money to get another phone because I spent all my money on Tyler the Creator tickets that I impulse bought. Like, my mom was gonna kill me. Like, this is what I was thinking. I was like, she's probably calling me right now. Like, what if she's texting me and I'm not like responding or anything? She's going to murder me, baby. I'm going to die. I'm gonna die. So I had to accept my fate at that moment. And while we were waiting for Blood Orange to get on stage, I was like writing down an obituary in my head. Anyways, Blood Orange gets on stage, you know, I'm grooving, kind of like still distressed, you know, dancing along to music. And I was thinking with my bright mind, very, very bright, I had an idea. Why don't I do the little Snapchat location thing, right? And so I wait until after his set is over, and then I turn around to my brother and his girlfriend, and I'm like, Snapchat. Like, you know, they have the little location thing. And she's like, yeah. And I'm like, let's see if we can do it that way. And then her data wasn't working, so we couldn't do it that way. And I was like, somebody stole my phone. So my brother's girlfriend was like, oh my God, like, I have to go pee so bad, like, I need to sit down, my legs hurt, blah, blah, blah. And I'm like, okay, like, go to the bathroom now before Tyler's set starts, you know, because they're going to get rowdy and crazy and people are going to start moving and stuff like that. White people are going to start saying the N-word, like, a lot, and it's going to make me feel really uncomfortable. Like, just go pee and hopefully make it back safe and before he gets on. When I tell you, right as she left, the music, like, the lights went low, and then he walks out on stage, and I'm like, one, she's not gonna make it back, two, she's gonna get trampled. Like, oh my god. Three, my man's is on stage. So my eyes go directly to him, my husband, the love of my life. And I'm like, screw my phone. At this point, screw my phone. I don't care about my phone. What phone? Did I lose a phone tonight? Because I didn't. And so, me and my brother are there, like, jumping around and dancing and singing and grooving along and all that kind of stuff. And, like, I don't know. It was like heaven, you know, shines down upon you once in a lifetime. Maybe. Who knows? My brother's girlfriend comes back and hands me my phone. And I'm like, what? I was like, where did you find it? Like, what happened? Like, where was it at? Did you find it in, like, the bathroom stall? Like, where did you have to go to collect my phone? And thank you. And she was like, oh, I just asked the bartender, and the bartender had it. And I was like, Jesus, thank you so much for giving my brother this amazing girlfriend. I love you. I was like, thank you so much. And I'm surprised because when I got my phone, not one call or text from my mother at all. And I was like, thank God that she didn't call me, because I would have executed right then and there. Especially because this is my first concert. But like, Jesus seen, he was like, you're such a good child. Here you go. Here's a blessing, like, right there. And so, I got my phone back before my favorite song, which is Puppet, and I cried. I will insert video here.
This is fucking...
Yes, I do have an emotional connection with that song, more than I would like to. But yeah, I had a really fun time at the concert. Like, it was really fun. I'll insert some clips right here. Time for that being my first concert, that was like one ticket super cheap, especially for floor. And I got to see my man's. I've been listening to his music since I was like seventh grade, so it was a very full circle moment for your girl. And I was just like, I love him. And I like see my phone, and my phone is at like 1%, and I'm like, what are we gonna do? Because like, my brother's girlfriend's phone was dying. Like, my brother's phone was charged, but he does not have a SIM card, which doesn't make any sense to me. I mean, like, whatever. Jesus. Just seen and was like, I see you struggling, girl. Turn your phone off and then turn your phone back on. And then they bestowed upon me 10% so I can call my mother because our ride flaked on us. Not saying that I have a problem with that, but like, we had a problem with that. And my mom had a problem with that. And if you're watching the story, Mom, I was a good child this entire time. I didn't touch anything. I didn't do anything illegal because I'm a good child. I had like 3 asthma attacks. So I was jumping around. I had a Charlie horse in my entire body and my voice was going away. And then I got sick after the concert, but I was sick before the concert. But on the day of the concert, I wasn't feeling sick, you know what I mean? So like, everything just came together. So I've been gone for a really long time, like very long. And I didn't mean to be gone for like a really long time, but like everything, like home situations weren't like como si dice good. So I had to like wait until we like moved in order to start making videos again. So like, it's a weird story on how I graduated, honestly, to me. But here's a short little story time too, about how I almost did not graduate. So like, on the last day of school for seniors, my guidance counselor calls me in and she's like, hi. And I'm like, hey, what's up, girl? Like, you see, I passed all my classes, maybe with D's, but like, D is a passing grade to me. So therefore, I'm graduating, right? And she was like, about that. And I'm like, what do you mean about that? And she was like, so I may have like miscalculated your credits, right? Because mm-hmm. That's so quirky. And you have to take an extra class. And I was like, what? And she's like, you have to take an extra class. I'm so sorry. But like, it's not affecting me. It's affecting you. You may not graduate. And I was like, my mom's gonna kill me. And guess what? She did. Called my mother. And was like, hey, Tanita's mom. My mom was like, hey, Tanita's guidance counselor. She's like, so Tanita has to take an extra class. And my mom was like, what? And she was like, don't worry, it's gonna be super easy and she's gonna get it done like that. I know your daughter. Your daughter is like so ambitious and she's gonna get it done and da-da-da-da, like rambling on. And I'm like, oh my god, lady, like just assign me the class so I can get it done before I have an emotional breakdown in your office again. I don't want this to happen, especially on my last day. Well, it was my last day because I only showed up to the school after that to get my cap and gown. Guess what? I finished the freaking classes in record time, like a, not even a day, like 12 hours. I finished the classes in 12 hours. I finished the class in 12 hours and it wasn't like an online class, you know what I mean? Anyways, I went to go pick up my cap and gown and she was like, I'm really proud of you for like finishing it and you know, you're gonna do great things in life, and blah, blah, blah. And I'm like, okay. And so, you know, I graduated, walked the stage. Here's some videos of that, because that's interesting. All right, but still the growing pains that keeping me up at night. Anyways, that's where I have been. I have graduated, working on getting my license and a job. And people are gonna be like, why don't you have a job yet? And that's because I don't wanna Uber or like Lyft places because there are so many people, especially black girls, getting kidnapped and put into like sex trafficking. And I don't trust people, you know what I mean? Anyways, but that's what I've been up to. And yeah, I'm gonna go to the outro now. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment. And leave suggestions down below or in my DMs on Instagram. Because I need suggestions for videos. Because I don't have ideas all the time. And oh my god, almost forgot to say this. But I'm so excited. I'm starting a new thing on my channel, which I've been wanting to do for a really long time, but just haven't because I'm lazy. And I also haven't had a mic, but I am going to start 3 a.m. covers. What those are, cover videos at 3 a.m. hopefully, if I stay up that late. But like, covers at night is the gist, you know what I mean? Because covers during the day are just not as fun. Singing during the day is not as fun. Kind of like karaoke-esque situation going on, you know what I mean? So yeah, that's pretty much the video. I don't know when I'm gonna be posting my first 3 a.m. cover, whatever, but expect the unexpected. It could be right after this and you don't know. It's probably not going to be, maybe about like next week, but you don't know that. You know, you hear it from me, okay? I'm a very untrustworthy person sometimes. But yeah, that's the end of the video. Oh yeah, I'm gonna leave my music down below. I just wanted to like let you guys know that I make music, and thank you for listening to my music. The fact that one of my songs really got to like 200-ish views is really like weird, but like good to me, because you guys like what I do apparently. Also, if you guys want to go like leave like feedback down there, then please go ahead. I'm gonna leave the link to my two songs down below, and now I think I'm officially done. Peace, love, and kisses. Bye guys.